Hello and welcome to Just One More Watch. And today, back with a review of one of my favourite watch brands, Casio. I've got a few grey hairs. I remember the 1980s. And if you were at school in the 1980s, you had to have a Casio watch. And the king of the Casios was the Casio calculator watch. If you had one of them, you were the coolest kid in the playground. I didn't have a Casio calculator watch. But now that I'm allegedly an adult, I've got two of them. Yes, that's right, I am Schwarzkopfing with Casio calculator watches. So without further ado, let's flip the camera and get on to today's review. So there are four Casio calculator models currently available to purchase. The simplest of them is the CA53. The little rubber keys remind me of the old ZX Spectrum 48K computer. If you're old enough to get that reference, perhaps that's the one for you. Next up is the CA56. Again, similar looking with the rubber keys, but a slight change on the bracelet. These are available in a variety of different colors. As you can see, the slightly blingy gold one there, and a number of more bright colors also. Finally, the most expensive, the top of the range, is the DBC 611. This one is advertised as a data bank, $42 though. It's getting up there. Also available in a rather nice, shiny, blingy gold color, if that is your cup of tea. The one I'm going to look at today, the one I've got two of, is the DCB32. Now this one, slightly more modern looking, if indeed you can call a calculator watch modern. And there's a reason I purchased this one, I'll tell you when we get to look at my own examples. So in terms of dimensions and specifications, let's talk about weight first of all. The resin one weighs a frankly ridiculous 34 grams, barely feels like you're wearing a watch at all. The full bracelet, only 20 grams more at 54 grams. Again, really very light for a metal bracelet watch. At its widest point, 38 millimeters across the top there, tapering down to 32 mil at the bottom, 22 millimeter lug width, and 50 millimeters from lug to lug. A nice curve on the watch there, as you can see as well. Really important for the way that the watch fits on the wrist. It really does tend to hug the wrist nicely. I'll pop it on my wrist a little bit later on and show you that. So the bracelet on this one isn't amazing. You don't really expect miracles for the paltry asking price. As I said, this one's a decade old. It hasn't held up too badly, but these are rolled links. The whole thing's a little bit rattly. The clasp only has a single point of engagement. It is signed though, which is quite nice, and there are heaps of micro adjustable holes to make sure that you get a good fit. Now, I tend to buy a lot from eBay, but I buy my Casio watches from Amazon. Not only are the prices usually just as good, but you tend to get the original boxes rather than just the watch shoved into an envelope with a tag if you're lucky, as tends to be the case on eBay. Now, one of the reasons I love these Casio watches, apart from their incredible prices, is that the digital modules are packed full of features. And this one, the 2888 module, is no different. Features a large and easy to read LCD screen with three main lines of information. On the top left there, you see the day of the week. Now, if you press this top left button there once, you can see that this one is set to English. I do speak English, albeit with a Scottish accent, but the watch also speaks Portuguese, Spanish, French, Dutch, Danish, German, Italian, Swedish, Polish, Romanian, Turkish, and Russian. So you can have the day there displayed in your native language. Beneath that, we have the time, and beneath that, we have the year and the month and the day. Now, this features an automatic calendar until 2099, so in theory, once you set it once, you'll never have to reset that, unless, of course, you manage to live beyond 2099. Accuracy for this model is a stated plus or minus 30 seconds per month, and it's powered by a single CR2025 lithium cell. In 10 years' time, when you do have to replace the battery, these are readily available for about $1, and it's a fairly easy job to swap them over yourself. So the top right button is the backlight. There's a single LED in the bottom left-hand corner here. It's not electroluminescent, but it is more than capable of lighting up the whole of that LCD display. If you hold it down for a couple of seconds, you can see there, it pops it into something called auto light mode. Now, this is quite useful if you do a lot of work at night. If you tip the watch at an angle, you see the light coming on there? I'll tip it back flat. So, oh, didn't work that time. There you are. So the watch senses effectively when you bring it up to look at the time and will turn on the backlight. I would imagine that drains the battery far, far faster than the quoted 10 years, so I'll turn it off there. Also, if you put it into time set mode and hold that button down again, you can see it's flipping the middle of those little buttons there. It's flipping it from between 1 second and 3 seconds of the backlight. I keep it down at 1 second again to avoid draining the battery. If you press the bottom right-hand button here, it alternates the main time display between 12 and 24 hour modes. Now, if you hold this one down for a couple of seconds, you'll see daylight savings time DST appear in the top right corner there. Again, very useful if you live in a country which features daylight saving time like I do over here in Australia. But most of the action on this watch is down here in this bottom left button. First press brings up the data bank. Now, this is a bit of an anachronism, but may be useful if you lose your phone and you're incapable of remembering numbers. You can store a total of 25 data entries here, and 8 letters, followed by 15 numbers. So you can have a name at the top and a number in the bottom. I programmed a few in just to see how easy it was. That isn't actually my dad's phone number, and that isn't actually my mum's phone number there, in case you get any ideas. Relatively painless process entering those in. Now, because of the 10-year battery, if you have real difficulties remembering passwords or PIN numbers, it might not be a bad option to have 25 of them stored in your watch. Just don't lose your watch. Pressing that button again, back to the time. If we press it twice this time, we're into the calculator mode, and I guess this is the raison d'etre of the watch, as it is a calculator watch. Again, fairly easy to operate here. The keyboard, not the best. Three times three. Does indeed equal 9. Useful that it also has the time permanently displayed down there if you're having so much fun with basic mathematics that you lose track of the time. Now, when you're in calculator mode, if you press this button here, it brings up EX. This is a currency exchange mode. So using the calculator features of the watch to change between two different currencies, that's as much as I know. I haven't really investigated this one further. Single press brings it back out to the time. So, on to the third press of this bottom left button, brings up the alarms. Now, there are 5 alarms. Your master alarm has a snooze feature, followed by 4 other single set alarms. After the alarm is a stopwatch. Now, I think a stopwatch is a genuinely useful feature to have on a watch. Again, pretty straightforward. Start, stop, and reset. Press it once more, and you're back into the time. But if we go through 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, there's a dual time feature here. Now, this is great if, like me, you have friends or family living in a different time zone. I've got this one set to London. If you press that button in the bottom right again, you can also change this one to daylight savings mode. Again, very, very useful feature there. And to set the time, you hold down the top left and it brings up the flashing seconds hand. You can then cycle through the year, day, date, hour, minute, and indeed language, and so on. Quick look at the case back there, all pretty straightforward. Stainless steel case back with 4 easy to operate at home screws, and conveniently a list of its features. Casio does like to advertise its features list, and there it is, even printed on the case back. But only water resistant, this one. One of the few minor drawbacks of this watch is that really, you don't want to be getting this one wet. Okay for doing the dishes, but I wouldn't be taking it in the shower, and I certainly wouldn't be taking it anywhere near a swimming pool. So let's pan back out a little bit, get these two on my wrist, and see how they wear. So here's the bracelet model, first of all, sized up for my 7-inch wrist. I think it looks pretty good, 50mm lug to lug, but then that curve means it sits nice and flat, hugs the wrist. Nice little signed bracelet there, as I showed earlier on. Definite bit of geek chic with this one. And same again for the resin version there. I must admit, this one is my favorite of the two. The strap on this, the resin strap, not the finest offering by Casio. I much prefer the strap that's on the AE1200, the Casio Royale. But this watch does have one more trick up its sleeve.
a little bit of a party piece because of those 22 millimeter lugs. And there it is. Because they've got 22 mil lug width, if you've got a bit of a watch collection happening, chances are you've got a few 22 millimeter straps. I actually bought this resin version of the watch because I had this lovely handmade calf vachette leather strap lying around without a watch to fit it on. And there we are, it found its home on the Casio. And look at that, a calculator watch on a Milanese. Kinky or what? Not to everybody's tastes, but a lot of fun, I think very much in keeping with the fun ethos of these watches. Not a lot of water resistance, as I mentioned, and the glass, this plastic crystal does tend to scratch up quite a lot. I would be buying a $5 tub of Polywatch with these ones. That does tend to help. But an awful lot of fun, these watches, they really are.
So there you have it, the Casio calculator watch. Perhaps not the most practical everyday timepiece, and has most certainly been superseded by the average mobile phone several decades ago, but nonetheless an awful lot of fun and a bit of retro cool on your wrist for not an awful lot of money. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.